Better be the last video. I don't want another freaking timeout.
Belmont scare on Thursday night. Second half, all trouble. And now Duke will be forced to foul. They're going to put Alexander at the line. Bob Huggins takes over in his hometown
of West
Virginia.
Dude, I have
born
to eat someone.
And raised a Mountaineer, back coaching his alma mater where he was a great player. 1977 grad. A great history of success at Cincinnati especially, but also came through the ranks at Akron and took over a program that had been to the Elite Eight and the Sweet 16 in two out of the last 3 years, came in and changed their style, kept what was
score 7-8
philosophy, which is
you look very lovely, don't touch me,
instituted his very tough man-to-man defense,
who's
and it was apparent
here
in the second half here.
That's
a wonderful job he's done at coaching this team.
Yeah, 27 wins a year ago under John Beilein, NIT champions. And West Virginia on the way to the 26th victory of the season. Huggins just joined that 600 win club this year as well as Henderson tries to power up and in two.
That's a lot of wins for for anybody at any
losers
level. And he's done it at places that weren't
them
necessarily great basketball before he got there. The Duke team is going to leave.
Yeah, those rich
Mr.
bastards.
Huggins has punched their tickets. The three-point shooting has evaporated with them in their last three games. And as a result, they're going home
you
early.
Right there in the
bounces him down. Henderson, as you look at his numbers career during the tournament, Bob, these are eliminations. Three times out in the first round, eight times out in the second, but not today.
And one time to the Final Four. Six coaches in the Big East Conference have taken teams to the Final Four. That's quite a record. Johnny West, the son of the famed Jerry West. One of the greats in Mountaineer history and NBA history. In the game.
Slam.
Now, there's been some great players. Alexander for one, Jerry West. Don't forget Hot Rod Hundley. Former first-round draft pick out of West Virginia. And the Mountaineers continue to power in.
Valve.
16 points for the junior gun out of Spring Hill, Florida.
West Virginia got the ball again.
My boy, you gotta wonder what's happening in Morgantown as this Mountaineer team is headed to Phoenix.
I think there's a little celebration going on in Morgantown. Take me home, country roads, baby. We're on their way to Phoenix.
It's gonna be a good game. Time out, home, I'm gonna eat everyone.
Up, Duke. Bob, you worked so hard for so long, and only one team. That's what's tough. Only one team.
Loser, loser. Can't afford anything. Loser.
Every other team in college basketball went into their season with a loss, other than the NCAA champions or the NIT champions. Duke had a terrific season.
It's over.
17-point game for Ruoff. Inside, Paula still working hard. Russell's up too. Henderson takes his seat on the floor. And it has been rough from the start. And that's an understatement.
Desire leads to intensity. Intensity leads to physical play.
Ahead, West Virginia will come in with confidence. The Arizona win by 10, and now you walk in and say, we just knocked off the two-seed Duke.
Yeah, well, they're going to have to play either Xavier or Purdue, which are two confident teams as well. We're going to see them here momentarily.
God, I don't
Anderson, two more. And time running out on Duke.
Yes!
Virginia, Phoenix, here they come. A dominating second half by the Mountaineers of West Virginia. On to the Sweet 16. Our final score, West Virginia 73, Duke 67. Let's see now to Greg Gumbel in New York.
What an impressive performance by the seventh seed Mountaineers, who move on.
Yes.
They eliminate number two seed Duke 73.
Let me show you my bracket.
We'll be sending you off to Omaha, where
I had Arizona winning that game, but
awaiting game two out of Washington.
Duke loses after that.
That one will come.
Seeing this one. I had Arizona winning.
Right after this.
But then I had Duke losing, so I win anyways. Tell you what happens.